What do you think of when you see a Shriner? Their unique red hats, their colorful parades? What about helping kids? Shriners Hospitals offer some of the world's best orthopedic spinal cord and burn medical care to children totally free of charge. And they combine that care with innovative teaching and progressive research programs. Sure, the Shriners have a lot of fun, but helping kids is a part of that fun. If you know a child that they could help, call this number. Shriners, having fun and helping kids.
For the best sports in Lorain, that's TV 20, Lorain City Schools Television.
Welcome, everyone, to Grafton Midview High School, the site of tonight's sectional final action featuring the Admiral King Admirals and the Medina Bees. Don Vincent along with Daryl Maynard on the Cool Cat 1380 and TV 20, Lorain City Schools Television, joining us for the broadcast this evening. Tonight, the Admirals are on the road. I still kind of find that kind of funny. A little bit closer to home than Medina, but they're on the road. They'll be wearing their road uniforms. Medina will be the home squad in their whites with the green and gold trim. Again, your Admirals will be wearing the gold uniforms. Yes, you were pointing.
I was just stating that the both schools showed up well tonight.
Oh, it's actually a very good point. You look at a game like this, and you kind of wonder how well it will be attended. They are set for a full crowd here at Midview High School. They've even got the extra seats up at the end of the gym here. So they're certainly anticipating a decent-sized crowd. Would anticipate that it'll get a little bit larger as the evening goes. This is game number one of two tonight. The second game featuring a couple of out-of-county teams, but I think Strongsville and North Olmsted in game number two tonight. But before we get to that point, we've got to take care of business in this particular game. The Admirals coming in at 13-7. Michael Scott has got his club primed for this game, Daryl.
And it's just like we talked before. You want to make sure your team is in all cylinders, clicking on everything and ready to go when it comes to tournament time. And that's something he's been able to do. A tough start of the season, the second half's turned it around, put things together, and when you get into the tournament, you need to be hot. You need to have momentum, because sometimes that'll help out more than just actual talent.
Well, one of the ways you always measure how Michael Scott feels about a game or where they are in the game is you kind of look at his attire. He'll always show up dressed very dapper. I mean, he's always dressed to the nines already. I mean, we've not even tipped off yet. He's got the jacket off and sleeves rolled up. So you know that he's coming to this game with some intensity. He's ready to go. We talked a little bit a few moments ago about the fact that this team came in with a very confident swagger to them, and they all kind of just nodded and said, hey, you know, all right, we're ready to go. And Michael's got that same attitude tonight, I'm sure.
And it reminds me actually of the Holiday Classic, and yeah. I hate to go back to that, but that's the last game that I did that featured Admiral King. And you know, they had a letdown the night before. Didn't get the victory when they thought that they would. And Coach Scott came in and pretty much got him off the bus, got him dressed, and got him in for opening tip. Didn't bring him in early.
And both of the coaches being introduced to a nice round of applause. Michael Scott for Admiral King, Jody Peters for Medina. They met at midcourt, shaked hands. That'll probably be the last time those guys communicate significantly until postgame. And we'll see what's going on from there. Interestingly enough, one of the players that you see moving out and shaking the hand of Coach Jody Peters is Paris Hilliard. Paris normally wears number three for the Admirals. He's injured. Cannot jump right now, as a matter of fact. The kind of side report that I got, and I'm not going to state this as a matter of fact, but my understanding is that he actually broke his foot. That's going to hurt this Admiral King squad. He's a senior leader, senior guard, handles the ball very well, shoots very well, and it's probably the reason we're seeing Chris Kimbrough in the starting lineup for the Admirals this evening.
Yeah, I mean, that's a strong possibility, but you look at their backups. I mean, you know, a freshman, a sophomore, Adrian Casey, Darrell Williams, Dominic Price. Of course, Price will be the main man, I believe, coming off and filling that role. But once again, you're only as good as how deep you are. You've got to be able to take, you know, if you do lose somebody, you've got to have someone else step up in their place. And I'm sure that Coach Scott feels confident about the guys that are sitting on the bench, even though they might be sitting on the end of the bench.
Well, let's go ahead and take a look at the starting lineups. We're announcing them here in the gym. Tonight's starting lineups are brought to you by Buckeye Community Bank, located in the center of Sheffield. Buckeye Community Bank, the way banking should be. For the Medina Bees, coming in at 10-11, coached by Jody Peters, they'll start 6'2 senior guard Paul Glass, along with Clay Mullenkamp, a 6'1 senior guard. One of the forwards will be Dylan McBride, 6'4 junior, and he'll join Will Hotelling, a 6'2 junior forward, and then Russ Micah will round out the starting lineup, a 6'4" senior for Medina. For the Admiral King Admirals, 13-7 on the year. Michael Scott's going to lead them into today's battle. They'll start a freshman, interestingly enough, 5'8" guard, Chris Kimbrough. He plays like an older guy, though. I got to tell you that right now. Along with him will be four seniors, 6'4" guard, Derek Mosley, Jordan Simmons, a 5'11" guard, and then the two forwards underneath, the guys that are really explosive for this Admiral King squad, Jay Pinkerton, a 6'5" forward, and the big guy underneath, Danny Hoskins, 6'6" and full of muscle.
And the great thing is they both got beautiful touch on their shots. They're not afraid to take a shot from outside. They both got good release, good arc, and they can definitely line it up from the outside. But what they want to do is do the dirty work down low.
Admiral King and their away unis, they'll be working left to right across your radio dial and your TV screen on TV 20 Lorain City Schools Television. Good to have Joe Bach along, as always. Did I say left to right? I meant right to left.
I just agree with anything you say.
You know which way we're heading. All right, let's get it straight. Danny Hoskins will go up against Russ Micah, and we're about to set to get this one underway. 8 minutes on the clock. The officials are ready to go. Let's play some basketball. Ball's up. Micah controls the tip for Medina. Works it forward to Mullenkamp. He works it left side. Shot no good at that side. Tip underneath no good as well. Ball still battled for. Mosley had it for a second, but then had it ripped away. Dylan McBride works into the lane, flips it out to Mullenkamp, and he'll set the Medina offense. Man-to-man defense by the Admirals. And Mullenkamp almost walked with the ball before he hands off to McBride. Works it toward the baseline. Can't quite handle it there. Micah struggles with it, and it's picked up by the Admirals. They're going to push. It's Mosley. Goes behind his back. Works to the right side. Gets it out top. Kimbrough, he'll set the offense. Simmons well outside the arc. Right wing. Looks inside. Nothing doing there. He'll find Hoskins. Hoskins spins into the lane. 8-footer's good. It'll be a long night if Medina doesn't do something to stop that. Full court pressure by the Admirals. Mullenkamp beats the timeline. Kimbrough right in front of him the whole way down. Beats him into the lane. Traveled. Will head the other way.
And a great job of Hoskins letting his man go, stepping up in the paint and getting a body on him. When he got to the middle, he said, I don't know if I want to take it up against the big man. I need to get rid of it.
Medina looks like they'll bring man-to-man pressure for at least the first part of this game. Simmons with the ball. Lob pass goes into Hoskins, and he gets shoved. Foul will be called on Paul Glass, I believe. He's the guy that made the initial contact. I actually checked that. I think they're going to call that on Hotelling. In fact, that is the case. His first, team first. Pinkerton will get the ball in. It'll be Hoskins outside the arc, right side, about 5 feet off the baseline. Tries to work toward it. Mosley gets the ball at the top of the key. Tries the pass down toward Hoskins. That one bounces out of bounds. One turnover apiece. Here comes the full court pressure. Admirals will run this all game long if they have the opportunity. Mullenkamp will work against Kimbrough. Pushes off a little bit, wasn't enough to catch the foul. Then he beats the timeline. Still with the ball. He'll work it to the right side and Glass. Glass deed up by Simmons. Couple dribbles towards the baseline. Tries, thought about the shot, stepped out of bounds, no call there. And an errant pass will end up in the Admiral King bench. Will head the other way.
And right now you just see some sloppy play from both teams, just bad passes, maybe just a little excited about the game tonight.
Kind of a sense of who gets the first run in will dictate the pace of the game. Left side to Mosley, looks underneath. Simmons was there for a second. Mosley will step inside the arc and wedge the ball between the glass and the rim. That's a turnover, technically. Actually, no. Admiral King's keeping it. All right. No problem there. Inbounds pass comes to Kimbrough. They'll find Hoskins. Hoskins will spot the 15-footer straight on. Left that one short. Hit the front of the iron. McBride with the rebound. He'll get it off to Mullenkamp. Mullenkamp looks toward the baseline, and Hotelling missed the shot. Big pressure defensively. Altered that one. At the other end, Hoskins flips to Jordan. Jordan looks underneath. Bounce pass goes to Hoskins. Looks inside. Simmons can pop that three-pointer. Watch for it. Mosley well outside right wing after the cross-court pass. Simmons dribbles into the lane. Kimbrough, he'll work left side. Little scoop shot, no good. Rebound pulled down by Mullenkamp. He wants to push, goes behind his back. D'd up very nicely by Kimbrough. Loses it temporarily. Nice ball handling by Mullenkamp. Works toward the baseline. It was Micah with the shot, no good. Hoskins with the rebound. Kimbrough forward to Mosley. thought about going, it just wasn't there for him. Back out top to Kimbrough. Pinkerton stops at the left elbow, 15-footer, misses that one, a little bit weak. Hoskins pokes the rebound away, collects it, works his way into the lane. Another 8-footer, hard off the back of the iron. Rebound battled for, and in the hands of Medina, called the timeout just in time. It's a 30-second timeout, so we'll keep it right here. 5:12 left in the first quarter, and Admiral King's up by a deuce. So you're talking almost 3 minutes worth of basketball action and 2 points on the board.
Yeah, well, I mean, on defense for the Admirals, they're just getting up on their men, kind of filling lanes. Medina rushing into shots, not taking a lot of time. On the other end, Admiral King's had a chance to get the ball, but they've tried to work it down low to Hoskins, but the Medina's done a good job of pushing him out of the paint and getting him up towards the free throw line in that area, making him have to work a little bit. And when he does get down there, of course, Medina's helping out down low. The guards are dropping, so that's going to help them out. But maybe just a little bit of jitters for both teams.
Hey, and one of the things you're going to need to watch for is Medina's doing a real nice job bringing the ball up. They're facing the pressure, and they're handling it. Not particularly well, but they're handling it. But once they get into that pattern, they're getting a little backside cut.
Yeah.
And that's being real effective for them. It'll be Medina ball out on the side to clean it up, a little bit of water near the Medina bench. Following the timeout, that's taken care of. Let's go ahead and play some ball. 5:12 left in the first quarter, 2-0 in favor of the Admirals. Medina to inbounds, facing a five count. They finally do get it into Glass, and he'll work against Simmons. Man-to-man defense still by the Admirals. Look for that the majority of the evening. Glass still with the ball, works left side, finds Micah. Micah works to the top of the key. McBride spots a three, that one long. Hoskins rips down the big rebound. And he'll bring it up. No, work forward to Simmons. Simmons, right side outside the arc, back out top to Kimbrough, resets the offense. They work to the baseline and Pinkerton, back out to Mosley. Looks inside, nothing doing there. A couple dribbles to the top of the key. Kimbrough three, that one a little bit short. Rebound battle for, pulled down by Hotelling. He'll get it off to Micah, and finally into the hands of a guard. Mullenkamp wants to control the offense. Hotelling outside the arc, about 10 feet off the baseline, left side. They'll flip it out top. Glass, he'll spot the three, in and out. Rebound goes to Hotelling, back up, no good. Rebound goes to Hoskins. That's what, rebound number 4 for him already? Kimbrough outside the arc, right side, finds Mosley. Mosley will work to the top of the key. Simmons will step inside the arc, fire the long bomb. That one no good. Big rebound by Hoskins. Goes up strong off the glass and two. Hoskins with all 4 points in the game thus far. 3:57 left in the first quarter from Midview High School in Division I sectional final action. Paul Glass with the ball for Medina. Works to the left side in Micah. He'll kick it back out top to McBride, and right side now goes to Mullenkamp. To the baseline in Glass, 5-footer, that one left well short. Hoskins pulls down the rebound and goes on the run. Had Jordan up ahead. Jordan Simmons, that one not going there. Finds Pinkerton, gets it back. 8-footer, goes over top of everything. Missed badly that time. Picked up by Paul Glass. Glass goes long pass forward. Kimbrough gets in the way of it. Somehow ends up back in the hands of Hotelling. He'll flip it out to Micah. Micah will wait for the offense. No, he'll work it down to Hotelling. He'll spot the 15-footer in and out. No good. Hoskins, another rebound. Kimbrough will head down to the other end. Simmons spots long three. That one a little bit long. No good. Mosley with the rebound. Puts back. Shot partially blocked by Micah. Ends up with the ball in Hoskins' hand. Hoskins thought about the shot, kicks it out. Mosley, he'll spot the three right side, leaves it short. Another rebound for Admiral King. Nice pass underneath. Pinkerton with the deuce off of the assist. And a timeout called by Medina. See if they're going to take a full or a partial here. No, they're going to take the 30-second variety. It's 6-0 with 2:51 left in the first quarter, but you really get the feeling right now that Admiral King has almost established the pace and is having things their way, Darrell.
Yeah, I mean, right now they're doing whatever they want, and right now the head coach, Jody Peters, you want to upset a coach? Let the other team get about 4 or 5 offensive rebounds in the same series, and you're going to see a very unhappy head coach.
I don't think there's any question about that. And on the other side of the ledger, Michael Scott's going to be pretty pleased right now with the fact, number one, that his team is getting those rebounds. But the thing that's going to concern him is that Medina's getting a lot of decent looks. They're taking good shots. They're just not hitting them.
Yeah, right now, I mean, Medina's 0 of 8 from the field. But eventually, they're going to start hitting shots. This is a time right now where Admiral King can kind of get the kinks out of the offensive set and get things moving for themselves. They can't expect this same pace to be this way through the entire game.
Medina will get the ball off the timeout. Admiral King will bring at least token pressure. Nate Miller into the game for Medina, wearing number 32 for those of us, for those of you joining us in the television audience. Out top is Skuban for Medina. Adrian Casey into the game for Admiral King. Thank you, partner. Appreciate you pointing those out. Ball poked away by Kimbrough. Also, Rashawn Lagarde in the game for Admiral King, wearing number 32. It'll be Mullenkamp to inbound. Kimbrough's directly in front of him. He'll get it into Miller. Miller will work across the top, spins to the top of the key, bounce pass goes inside. Hotelling thought about the shot, wasn't there for him. Miller will spot the three, that one no good. Rebound ends up in the hands of Adrian Casey. And they'll pass off and reset the offense. Kimbrough works right side, Casey. Casey will flip it out top to Mosley. Man-to-man defense still by Medina. Casey with the ball, works to the top, and Hoskins. Hoskins isn't too shy about shooting that. He'll throw up a three every once in a while. Works across the top, into the lane, layup, no, but he was fouled. Nice take by Danny Hoskins, very patient offensively.
Lullaby on that one, just kind of set him asleep. Defensive player just kind of lackadaisical, and then he had that crossover, two steps, and he got to the hole from the three-point line.
Pretty impressive drive. Team foul number two on Medina. Mullenkamp called for the foul. We'll send Hoskins to the line for two freebies. Hits the first. Give him 5 points on the evening already. There's only two people in the scorebook thus far. Pinkerton off the assist from Hoskins. And Hoskins with his 5 points. Substitutions coming in for both teams. Dylan McBride reports back in for Medina. Simmons will report back in for Admiral King. And Pinkerton waiting to come in for the shooter, I believe. That's the only reason he wouldn't be getting up. So he'll come in for Hoskins if Hoskins is able to knock this one down. 7-0 in favor of Admiral King with 1:58 left in the first quarter. Hoskins second is up and down. Give him 6 points, and he will go take a seat. Nice first quarter for Danny Hoskins.
And it's just like initially when we started talking, Hoskins is going to be the guy they're going to need to feed all night long. I know he's hungry, and you want to make sure he's got a full stomach by the end of the night.
Full court pressure again by the Admirals. Medina has a little bit of a chore just to get the ball in. But Paul Glass will wave everybody off. He thinks that he can handle it. He does so. Gets it across the timeline, working right side. Works into the lane. Layup blocked by Pinkerton. Picked up by Mosley. He wants to push. Right side of the lane. Gets bumped a little bit. It's going to go out of bounds off of Medina. Good defense by Medina getting back to the hole and shutting down the drive.
And you see Hoskins sit down for Admiral King. Medina think they can go to the hoop. Pinkerton steps up with the big block, helping out his team. That's a senior.
1:42 left in the first quarter. Pinkerton gets the ball back after the inbounds pass. Kimbrough up top, now Mosley. Mosley, left wing, flips it out top to Pinkerton. Waits for Simmons to clear. He'll work across the top of the key and goes Kimbrough to the right side. Cross court pass goes to Mosley. A lot of high action right now for the Admirals. Low pass goes into Pinkerton, finally along the baseline. Backs his way in. Nice turnaround, baby hook. That shot no good. Pinkerton's going to get called for the foul. Went a little bit too hard and too high over Dylan McBride's back. So Pinkerton will draw the foul. That'll be the first team foul on the Admirals. Medina yet to find a basket. And Admiral King not lighting it up. 8 points thus far in the contest. First quarter's got about a minute and change left in it. But they're shutting down Medina pretty well, at least at this point. Skuban gets the pass knocked back to him and then travels into the lane. So we'll head the other way. Turnover, Medina.
Right now, anything Medina's doing just doesn't seem to be working for him. They can't win.
Well, Danny Hoskins will report back in. Kind of surprised that that's the case, and Pinkerton will go sit down. Scott with a couple of coaching words of advice for Pinkerton as he comes to the bench. Just over a minute left, first quarter from Grafton. Simmons with the ball, works toward the baseline, pump fake, nothing doing there. Kimbrough spots the 18-footer. That one a little strong off the rim. Hoskins got the ball, tried to go up, but got tied up. Jump ball situation will head the other way. And give credit to Scott Chester, just in for Medina, for holding on to that ball when Hoskins was trying to go up.
Yeah, it takes a strong guy to go in there and hold the ball with Hoskins.
McBride gets the inbounds pass. He'll hand off to Miller. Miller wants to push the pace for the Medina Bees. Works into the lane. May have traveled. No call. Right side, Paul Glass spots the three. In and out. No good. Hoskins, another big rebound for the Admirals. crosses over, brings it up himself, and finally lets Kimbrough have a handle on it. Right side now, Simmons works toward the baseline. Hoskins again. Nice pass goes inside. Rashawn Lagarde on the books. Boy, I tell you what, when Hoskins hasn't been making the shots, he's been given the assists. He's got two assists thus far. 19, 18, 17 seconds left, first quarter. With the ball is Nate Miller from Medina. And the ball will be bumped out to Skuban. Skuban out top now. Chester, right side, it goes to Miller. Miller tries the baseline drive, travels. We're going to head the other way. Got up in the air, didn't know what to do with it.
Yeah, when you get that low, you've got to be able to put the shot up one way or another.
Just over 6 seconds left in the first quarter. Admiral King is going to be thrilled with a shutout here in this first quarter. Hoskins hustles down court, wants to get one more up on the board. Mosley spots the three. That one wouldn't have counted, even would have went. The end of the first quarter, it's 10-0 in favor of the Admirals. Nice first quarter for Admiral King. Medina's got some work to do. We'll be back with second quarter action right here on the Cool Cat 1380 and TV20, Lorain City Schools Television.
Freedom to think for yourself.
To disagree with the government.
Freedom to be equal.
To be different.
Freedom to raise a family.
To marry the man I love.
The freedom to worship the God of my choice.
To live with dignity.
The freedom to be me.
To be whatever I want to be.
Defending freedom for over 200 years.
Looking for the right color, the right style, the right price for your floor coverings? Well, you can find them all at Ted's Floor Coverings, the only place you need to shop for affordable custom flooring. Whether you're looking for area rugs, carpeting, laminates, ceramic, or marble, you'll enjoy browsing through one of the largest showrooms in Northeast Ohio. Their talented staff will even help with your design questions. Ted's is proud to showcase the Kathy Ireland Shades of America collection. Shop at Ted's Floor Covering, 668 Broadway, downtown Lorain, a local company committed to our community. Ted Kahlo, president.
I am Mike Delgado of American Midwest Mortgage. If you are looking to purchase or refinance a home, I can personally help guide you in selecting a perfect program that fits your budget. Whether it's a no money down, FHA, investment property, or one of the other programs that I can offer, put that side by side with our low interest rates for a great savings combination. If you want the professional, personal touch, then remember to call Mike Delgado at 440-308-1019.
Se habla español.
Sectional final action from Midview High School. How about that? The first quarter, Admiral King pitches a shutout.
Yeah, I mean, 10-0 right now. Medina's got to work on getting something off the top of the basket, like there's some cellophane sitting on top of it. But I'll tell you what, Medina, they're going to put some things together. They're going to put some points on the board. Admiral King better watch out, because, I mean, even though they're up, it's still only 10 points. They still only had 4 field goals in that first quarter.
It's a great point. I think Admiral King is going to be frustrated on that offensive end, but defensively they're going to be thrilled. This is a team, and Michael Scott has this attitude, the coach of the Admirals. He doesn't want anybody score anytime.
Well, then he should be happy.
He should be very happy. Lagarde inbounds to Kimbrough. The Admirals will be Pinkerton, Hoskins, and Simmons in the game as well. We'll set the Medina lineup for you in just a second. Pinkerton out top finds Kimbrough. Kimbrough works toward the baseline, and Hoskins. Simmons with the ball, almost straight on. Kimbrough outside the arc, right wing. Pinkerton will clear across the top, misses badly on the 17-footer. Gets a little round of applause from his bench, but you know he's not liking the result there. Medina will get the ball inbounds. It'll be Micah with the ball now. Works off to Glass. They've got Mullenkamp on the court as well. And out top, Glass almost travels. Micah will get it back to him. And we'll set the rest of the lineup. I think Hotelling's in there, as well as Dylan McBride. So now we've got everybody's lineups in there. McBride gets the ball along the baseline. Reverse layup, partially blocked by Kimbrough. Hoskins will go after a three. Got a piece of that one as well. Two block shots on one series. Kimbrough forward to Hoskins. Hoskins wants to go up strong. Off the glass, he got fouled. He'll go to the line for two. Well, Hoskins felt that one about midcourt. He wanted it.
Yeah, he was ready. He was. You could see his hands starting to tremble.
Foul is called on Paul Glass, his first, team third. Three fouls on Medina, one thus far on Admiral King. Hoskins will get a couple of freebies coming his way. Already has 6 points in the contest. Dips puts up his first. leaves it a little bit short off the front of the rim. Gotta hit the freebies. Even if you're ahead 10-0 to start the second quarter, you still gotta hit those. And unable to get the second one. Rebound battle for a couple bodies on the floor. Medina will come up with the ball. Glass wants to push, has it poked away, picked up by Mullenkamp. Mullenkamp works into the line, and finally Medina on the scoreboard. McBride with the deuce. Big round of applause from the Medina fans. Simmons thinking about a 25-footer, then thought better of it. Finds Lagarde. Lagarde will kick it back out. Simmons will take that three-pointer. In and out, no good. Rebound finally tracked down by Hotelling. Here come the Bees. Mullenkamp works it forward to Glass, and contact at the other end. They're going to call the foul on Lagarde. Didn't quite have his feet set as he took the contact. Send Medina's Paul Glass to the line. Glass, a 6'2" senior guard. .637 left. Again, second quarter action from Medina High School. Glass clanks the first one. Still 10-2, and Mosley will report back in for the Admirals. Lagarde will go sit down. Couple good minutes there for Rashawn Lagarde. He's taken on an interesting role. I mean, he is that role player. You need somebody to bang, he'll bang. You need somebody to go at the boards, he'll go at the boards. Missed the second free throw, gets his own rebound, and then drains it off the glass, does Paul Glass. So his first 2 points make it 10-4 in favor of the Admirals. Cross-court pass goes to Simmons, out top to Kimbrough. Frakes left, goes right, forces up a shot, gets bailed out. I don't think it would have been a really good shot had he been open to take it, but he gets bumped, so he'll go to the line for a couple of freebies. Foul called on Mullenkamp. That's his second.
No, it was good defensive positioning by the Medina player. But when you get that low underneath, they're usually going to give it to they're usually going to call the defensive player with the foul.
Kimbrough unable to hit the first. That one bounced on the rim about four times before it finally fell off. Crowd still coming into this evening's contest. Like, I think some folks for game two are already starting to show up. Kimbrough hits the second, finally gets himself into the board, and Medina commits a turnover off the inbounds pass. Mullenkamp couldn't quite track it down. So Admiral King will get the ball underneath their own hoop on the turnover. Talk about a turnaround here. Medina started to feel it, got their first score. Now Admiral King with an opportunity to bust this open a little bit more. Kimbrough works into the lane, fires out to Mosley, spots the three, got it! Mosley, his first points of the ball game, and it's a big three-pointer, makes it 14-4. Admiral King back out to that two-figure lead. Mullenkamp working against Kimbrough, man-to-man defense by the Admirals. Simmons overplays Glass, and he'll spot the deuce. Boy, he must have just stepped onto the line. That's 4 points for him. Kimbrough works right side to Simmons. Simmons looks toward the baseline and Hoskins, not open. Pinkerton loses the ball, tracks it down. He's on the floor with it. Ends up being in the hands of Hotelling for Medina. Works it forward. McBride, he's trapped out there. Gets it out top. Mullenkamp working against pressure, loses the ball, tracks it down. You're going to get a foul called on Kimbrough on the floor, no shot. And that was just an ugly series. I'm not sure how Medina was able to maintain possession of the ball, but they just hustled after it every time it was on the floor.
I mean, it was a good read and react from Medina on the offensive end. Admiral King just seemed to be playing out of their defensive set right there. Everyone going for a trap, going for a steal. Not just really getting set.
Subs in for both squads. Trotting onto the floor right now for Medina's Nate Miller. And for Admiral King, Darryl Williams reports in. He's a sophomore, 6 foot guard. He'll D up the inbounds pass. All right, pass will come out top for Medina. Paul Glass with the ball now. He'll flip it left side, finds Micah. Micah tries to work it inside. It's picked up by Mosley. Mosley, nice pass forward for Pinkerton. Sotson pops from about 5 feet. Shot might have been altered a little bit. Pinkerton having an off night thus far. Medina gets the rebound. Get it in the hands of McBride. Works to the arc. Flips it left side. Left baseline to Micah. He'll kick it out top to Miller. Miller will back off. 5:11 left, second quarter. Miller works into the lane. Gets bumped, and they're going to call a foul on Hoskins. Hoskins was the last man to arrive, but the first guy on the officials' list of who fouled whom. Four team fouls apiece, which is not a bad number at the 5:09 mark in the second quarter. Miller spot the first. clanks it off the back of the iron. Ben Skubon will come in for Medina. Sitting down will be Micah, so a little bit faster, smaller lineup for Medina right now. Miller's second is up, and that one's good. His first points of the evening. Here come the Admirals, leading by seven, 14-7. Mosley gets trapped. He works it out top, finds Williams. Williams will work left side, and a travel by Kimbrough will head the other way. Medina's working their way back into this one, Darrell.
Yeah, and I mean, I don't know if it's a fact that Medina's putting things together or Admiral King's just kind of losing control on the offensive end.
Be interesting to see if the Admirals are able to regather here. Nate Miller with the ball for Medina. Admiral King picking up at half court. They'll flip it right side to McRide now toward the baseline and Glass. He's about 10 feet off the baseline. Nice defense there by the sophomore Williams. But Glass able to drop it in for his sixth point of the ball game. 14-9 now. Favor of the Admirals. Mosley with the ball out top. He'll find Williams. Williams will look toward the baseline. It'll be Mosley kicking it out to Hoskins. Gets it back. Spots the three straight on. Felt it, but it wasn't there. Rebound goes off of Admiral King. Apparently the official wanted to make sure everybody saw that particular call. Simmons will trot back onto the court for the Admirals, and Darrell Williams will sit down. A couple nice minutes for Williams on the court. Nate Miller will handle the guard duties for Medina this time down the court. Looks towards Skubon. He wasn't available, so then he backed off. Still in the hands of Miller. Miller works into the lane. Nice little shovel pass underneath to Dylan McBride. He gets points three and four and make it a three-point lead, 14-11 in favor of the Admirals. Kimbrough, left side to Mosley toward the baseline, and Hoskins, nice baseline move, blocked from behind by Hotelling. He picks it up and starts to head the other way. Ball will go out of bounds off Medina. On the floor was Pinkerton, got run over by Skubon. I was waiting for somebody to call a foul, no calls.
Well, it's a great play by Pinkerton because when your shot's not falling, you need to find something else to do to help get your team back in the game or continue to be leading the game.
Subs in. Rashawn Lagarde reports in for Admiral King, and Mullenkamp will report in for Medina. Mosley to set things in action, works the ball into Kimbrough. 3:45 left, second quarter action. 14-11 in favor of the Admirals. They were out by 10 at the top of the quarter. Medina's worked their way back into this one. Simmons, now Mosley, nice bounce pass goes to Hoskins, sets his shoulder down, puts it up, and one. They're going to call a block on Medina. And that time, Hoskins was not to be denied. Team foul number five on Medina was called on Hotelling. Tell you, 6'6 and strong, matched up against 6'2 and a junior. I'm taking 6'6 every time. Hoskins completes the old-fashioned three-point play, gives him nine on the evening, makes it 17-11 now in favor of the Admirals.
Well, especially 6'6 with good court vision and a nice touch.
Yeah, it helped. That touch helps a little bit. Full court pressure again by the Admirals. They're going to pick up the intensity just a little bit. It's old-fashioned Admiral King basketball. Medina handles it by getting it to Mullenkamp across the timeline. He works it toward the baseline, and Skubon. Skubon tries the drive, shoves the pass out. It'll be Glass with the long three-pointer right side. Tip underneath that time by Hotelling, no good. Rebound, Hoskins. Kimbrough wants to push. Thinks better of that, slows things down just a little bit. Works left side. Mosley fakes left, goes right. Got it! And one. Mosley took the drive, made that little left fake, one dribble into the lane, hung a little bit and forced the shot up. Did a nice job just maintaining his balance in air. Foul was called on Nate Miller. Mosley unable to convert the old-fashioned three-point play, given five on the evening thus far, 19-11 in favor of the Admirals with under 3 minutes left in the second quarter. Out top with the ball is Miller from Medina. He'll flip it off to Skubon, deed up there by Simmons. Skubon looking for a little bit of help, no one moving. Glass gets the ball, deed up by Lagarde. Got a hand on the ball for just a second, but Glass was able to control it. Mullenkamp now, deed up by Kimbrough. Shakes and bakes a little bit, works into the lane, traveled, will head the other way. Had the right idea, couldn't get it done.
Well, the whole thing, Don, is how many times tonight have the guards for Medina been able to get down low, see Danny Hoskins, and then their feet kind of, they don't know what to do with themselves.
Admiral King with the ball now. 2.5 minutes left in the second quarter, up 19-11. Want to bust this back out to a two-figure lead. Pinkerton through the lane, misses the layup, goes hard off the glass. No dice there. McBride pulls down the rebound for Medina. He'll flip off to Miller. Miller will work left side now. Mullenkamp, top of the key is Glass. Left elbow, loses the ball temporarily. Kimbrough will pick it up, leave it off, gets it back, and taken away by Mullenkamp. One too many passes there. Mullenkamp goes the length of the court. Glass on the layup, no dice. Pinkerton rebound for Admiral King. Has it knocked away. Simmons will control and work to Kimbrough. Now Pinkerton's got to be confident in that shot. Hoskins had it knocked away at the other end. Mullenkamp's coming up big. Simmons goes back after it, steals it back, lays it off for Hoskins. Hoskins loses it temporarily. It's on the ground. It'll go out of bounds off Medina. No. I'm going to say it went off of Hoskins. I'm kind of stunned. Well, what do you do?
I guess I make an appointment to see my see my eye doctor this weekend.
I've got bifocals. Maybe I need the trifocals. All right, Medina will have the ball off of what we think is a missed call. A minute and a half left in the second quarter. Miller D'd up by Simmons out top, works the ball up top. He'll flip it left side to McBride. McBride D'd up by Pinkerton. McBride to Glass now, D'd up by Lagarde. Good movement away from the ball on both squads right now. And a travel on McBride. Well, head the other way. Boy, you know, if you just take away the travels, and I know you can't do this, but if you take away all the travels from Medina, it's a different game.
Oh, completely. But you just see how well the Admirals switch on defense.
Just over a minute left. First half action from Grafton. The Admiral's up 19-11. Hoskin gets the ball in the paint. Off to Pinkerton. Forces up an 8-footer. Thought he got fouled. No call there. Rebound Medina. Mullenkamp will work it up across the check. That's Miller working it up across the timeline. Drives into the lane. May have gotten shoved a little bit. Missed the running jumper. Kimbrough with the rebound. Gets it forward to Pinkerton. Pinkerton along the baseline. Tries to work in. Loses the handle. The official's going to say that he was fouled by Nate Miller. That'll be Miller's second foul. And I believe that will set the Admirals into the bonus. Indeed, that is the case. So it'll be a 1-1 for Pinkerton. Admiral King came out big in the first quarter, led at that point 10-0. They've let Medina kind of creep back into this one. Pinkerton hits the free throw to give him 3 points on the evening. Makes it 20-11 right now. You thought that Medina was right back in this one, as I was saying just a moment ago. The Admiral King reexerted themselves.
Yeah, a nice run put back by the Admirals. I'm sure it'll please the coach and please themselves, but that's something you have to do in tournaments. It comes, it goes. You need to be able to get the flow going.
Pinkerton rattles the second one in. Hoskins will sit down. Mosley in for him. Full court pressure again by the Admirals, especially after they score. They'll jump right into this. Ball will come in to Miller. And back to Mullenkamp. D'd up by Kimbrough. Crosses over a couple times, goes behind his back, loses it temporarily, still with the ball across the timeline now. May have shoved off. That's what Coach Michael Scott's looking for. You can see him in the background if you're watching this on Channel 20, Rain City Schools Television. Miller with the ball, jump stop at the arc, right wing. He'll hand off. That's Scott Chester. Chester working against big pressure, finds Glass. 19, 18, 17 seconds, second quarter clock. Glass along with Miller now, 14 on the clock. Simmons playing great defense. The Admiral King fans on their feet now, imploring their defense to continue on. Mullenkamp with the ball, works inside the arc. Taken away by Kimbrough, gets it forward to Lagarde. Long shot, maybe a little bit premature. 0.8 seconds on the clock. And one of the Medina players is going to get a little talking to because he just kind of kicked the ball up to the official. Gets the warning there. Darrell Williams has stepped onto the court for Admiral King. A lot of smiles over in the Admiral King bench right now. Pretty comfortable with what's going on. Coach Michael Scott says, everybody back up, no freebie layups. And there's the long pass to Pinkerton. He'll fire the last shot. That one will fall well short. But the Admirals not falling short here in the first half of play. They go into the locker room at halftime up 21-11 over a Medina squad that certainly was game in terms of trying to get work their way back into this one. But Admiral King had to reset themselves and take control of the game there in the latter part of the second quarter.
Today's high starting salaries make two-year degrees very attractive, but some careers require four-year degrees.
At top rate in Lorain County Community College, you'll find them all.
Over 30 associate degrees in 80 fields that pay more than ever.
The university partnership brings 8 universities and more than 30 degrees into Lorain County.
Get ahead the affordable way, your way.
Lorain County Community College for a real future.
Lorain School Employees Credit Union, 4459 Oberlin Avenue, Lorain. If you're an employee of the Lorain Board of Education or an employee's family member, you're eligible for the lowest rates, the best products, and the friendliest service and banking with Lorain School ECU. Speak with us about a membership today and start reaping the rewards of membership with Lorain School ECU. Phone 440-282-4600.
Your one-stop place for something really special is Impressions, corner of Oberlin Avenue and Tower Boulevard. T-shirts and sweatshirts personally designed to your specific needs. Anything from bears, trains to zebras, and specially designed hats as well. And don't forget Impressions, your one-stop spot for school jackets. See Dave, the designer expert at Impressions, Oberlin Avenue at Tower Boulevard, right here in Lorain.
Since 1921, your hometown financial professionals at First Federal Savings of Lorain have dedicated themselves to meeting the financial needs of their customers and surrounding communities. They offer a wide variety of financial investments as well as home mortgages to meet your every need. Loans on boats, cars, mobile homes, and other worthwhile purchases are also available. Whatever your financial need, First Federal Savings of Lorain is ready to help. 7 convenient locations to serve you in Lorain, Huron, Sandusky, Port Clinton, and now at 36690 Detroit Road in Avon. First Federal Savings of Lorain is an equal housing lender and FDIC insured.
I'm Bob Costas, and I've been broadcasting sports for a long time. Much of what I do is ad-libbed, but still one of the most important aspects of my job is being able to write. Narrations, essays, commentaries. It's essential to express those thoughts and concepts clearly and concisely. Good writing is essential for almost any career. And with today's advanced technology, the National Commission on Writing reports that the need to write well has never been more important. Writing is everybody's business.
Get you set for second half action from Midview High School. I almost said Medina. I've been doing some girls games down in Medina. It's actually Midview High School here in Grafton, Ohio. The Admiral King Admirals up 21-11 at the half. And interesting how the first couple minutes will go, Daryl. You would anticipate Admiral King wants to pick up the tempo again and really push. On the other hand, you really think Medina wants to control everything.
Yeah, I mean, what Medina wants to do is kind of get in the half court set, get good looks offensively, and when they have got to the middle or been able to break down guards from the front, they've been able to get pretty decent shots, you know, at the basket. Admiral King, they want to come out and run. They want to push this 10-point lead up as much as possible and go ahead and put any, just get the doubt in Medina's mind that they can come back.
Well, Medina get the ball on the alternate possession to start the second half. They'll be moving right to left across your radio dial or your TV screen if you're checking us out on Channel 20, Lorain City Schools Television. And a real quick foul called on Admiral King. I believe they got Chris Kimbrough. It'll be his second, team first in the half. Boy, that was a quick one. Mullenkamp with the ball for Medina, spins across the top, shovels a pass to the baseline and Glass. Glass working against Simmons, goes up, little double pump. First shot, no good, gets his own rebound, gets fouled on that attempt, and he'll go to the line for a couple of freebies. Foul's gonna be called on Jordan Simmons. 13 seconds into the game, Admiral King ends up with 2 fouls. Dylan hits the first of the free throws coming his way, gives him 5 on the evening.
And you see Glass being, getting in there, being aggressive and getting to the free throw line.
Second is also good for McBride. Admiral King needs to answer here if they want to maintain the momentum that they took into the locker room. Kimbrough loses it temporarily, picks it back up, finds Simmons. Simmons outside the arc, right wing. Flip it back up, and Kimbrough will center up. Simmons looking inside, nothing doing there. They'll reverse the ball to the baseline, left side. Mosley thought about the shot, no dice there. Simmons ties the baseline drive, cut off there by Glass. Kimbrough with the ball, works into the lane. Mosley, again, works it inside to Hoskins, flips it out. Pinkerton takes the three, that one no good off the front of the rim. Glass with the rebound, has numbers. Dylan McBride up front, stops and pops from eight, high off the glass, and two. 8 points for McBride, 21-15 now. Hoskins will work forward for Admiral King, flip it out to Kimbrough, right side to Simmons. Simmons outside the arc, looks to lob the pass in. He'll spot the three. That one a little bit short off the iron. Mosley with the rebound for Admiral King. Nice pass goes into Simmons. He was going to go up with the shot, got fouled on the lower half of his body. I think they'll call Paul Glass on the shove. In fact, that's exactly who they call. And they'll send Simmons to the line for a couple of freebies. .650 left. And the Medina bench and fans do not like the fact that Simmons is shooting. He was going up at the time, though. Simmons hits the first. It's his first points of the game. So now all of the starters for Admiral King have scored.
And I know you talked about Pinkerton getting his game in. I think that Simmons is someone that needs to get his game going
right.
And step up here in the second half.
Maybe he can get it started at the free throw line. Hit the first, drop the second. 2 points for him, make it 23-15. Here comes the full court pressure by Admiral King. Mullenkamp will work against Kimbrough, breaks the timeline, works left side to Glass. Outside the arc, deed up by Simmons. Works out top, it's McBride. Right side, Mullenkamp tries the baseline drive. Shovel pass goes to Hotelling. It'll be McBride with the three. That shot no good. Hotelling will track down the rebound outside the arc, well away from the basket. No one wanted to grab that one. Mullenkamp works across the top, finds McBride, deed up by Mosley. Glass along the right baseline, running scoop layup, uncontested. Gives him 8 points on the evening. 23-17 in favor of the Admirals. 6:10 left, third quarter action from Midview High School. Simmons with the ball, outside the arc, faked the shot, dropped it inside. Pinkerton got the little chippy off the assist. 6 points for Pinkerton. Admiral King looking, thought they were looking to trap press. They're going to call the ball out off of Mosley. Mullenkamp will inbounds to Glass, gets it back, works to the baseline, right block, gets fouled as he goes up for the shot. I tell you, I didn't see the contact.
It looked to me like Hoskins had great body control and just came down. If anybody would, I think it came from probably Kimbrough was actually the guy that came over for the block.
Well, Hoskins will get tagged for the foul. We'll send Mullenkamp to the line for a couple. Clanks the first one off the front of the rim. Well, you gotta have those freebies. 25-17, an 8-point lead for Admiral King with 5:48 left in the third quarter. Mullenkamp's second is good. It's actually his first point of the night. Kimbrough will come forward across the timeline for the Admirals. Crosses over a couple times, works to the free throw line, forces up an ugly 15-footer, misses everything. Might have been a pass for Lagarde. Tough to tell. Glass with the ball right now for Medina. Works with the 14-footer just about straight on. That one no good. Pinkerton rips down a rebound. He'll get it off to Hoskins. Hoskins will push a little bit for Admiral King. Finds Mosley along the baseline. Spots the three. In and out. Back in. Mosley with 8 points. 28-18. Admiral King back out to that 10-point lead that they got spotted to him in the first quarter. Actually, they earned in the first quarter. I don't want to make it sound as though it was given to him. McBride with the ball out top, deed up by Mosley, works right side to Micah. They'll go cross court, and you're going to get a foul called on Lagarde as he tried to work through a screen by Mullenkamp. This game's getting pretty physical. It'll be interesting to see how long that's going to continue.
Yeah, and I mean, it's something that we saw some fouls called early in the start of the second half here that probably weren't called in the first half, and you're kind of seeing these fouls get called a little more rapidly.
Medina with the ball after the foul. It'll be Nate Miller with the ball out top. Just came into the game for Medina. He'll hand off to McBride, get it back, starts to work right side, crosses over, works into the lane, facing a 3 second call if he doesn't get out of there. Shot by Mullenkamp, blocked, but they get it back, and nice pass goes underneath to Glass, and he gets the deuce. 10 points for Glass. Mosley forward for Admiral King, goes between his legs, spots the three. That one a little bit short. Battle for the rebound, no good. Saved back into Lagarde, and he'll drop in the easy one. There's a garbage bucket for you. We got to mark that one down. Timeout called by Admiral King. 30-second timeout. 4:26 left in the third quarter. The score is 30-20 in favor of the Admirals. And interesting choice to take a timeout right there by Admiral King's coach, Michael Scott. Despite the fact that they're up by 10, I don't think he's got confidence in where they are right now offensively. Defensively, I think they're probably okay. Offensively, just not finding it right now.
Yeah, I mean, I'm sure Coach Scott was looking at some better execution coming out of halftime. I'm sure he had some choice words to say to him. And you come back out, and you can see Medina's still hanging around. They're right there. All it takes is a little run, and they'll be, right back in. So Admiral King needs to work these things out. They're going to have to figure out that Hoskins can't do everything on his own. He's going to need Mosley, Kimbrough, Simmons, Pinkerton, maybe even someone else off the bench to step up and help him out.
See if the defensive intensity can lead to some offense for the Admirals. We're going to also see if Medina has an answer for the defensive pressure. At least token pressure right now by Admiral King. Miller working against Pinkerton, comes across the timeline, working right side, crosses over, works into the free of the throw line. Hotelling will get the ball, find Glass. Glass working against Lagarde, tries to force up a shot, knocked away, and picked back up by Glass. Works underneath the hoop, spins back into the lane, and the little shot forces up and gives him 12 on the evening. 30-22 in favor of the Admirals. Hoskins will spot the 15-footer right elbow, and Mosley will go up for the rebound, goes atop everybody's back, and gets whistled for the foul. His first. It'll be team fifth for Admiral King. That's not a good number. Medina will inbounds following the foul. Miller will handle the ball. Thought he had a break, wasn't there for him. Pinkerton steps away and then re-engages. Miller works into the lane, scoops it out. It's Scubon with the three, misses everything. Pinkerton rebound. He'll get it forward to Hoskins. Hoskins wants to shake and bake. Right side of the line, goes up for the little pass, and Hotelling's going to be whistled for the foul. That'll be his third. Want to remind everybody here on the Cool Cat, and certainly on, here on the Cool Cat more so, you can check out this game on video if you'd like. Channel 20 in Lorain, Lorain City Schools Television, will be broadcasting this game on the 6th at 3:30 and at 7:30. Want to invite you to join us then as well. Pinkerton off the inbounds pass, gets the deuce. That'll be 8 points for Pinkerton, and I guess we can stop talking about the fact that he lost his game in the first half because he found it here in the second. Medina with the ball. It'll be Chester working out top. Glass will spot the 18-footer. That one no good. Kimbrough with the rebound. Has the guard in front. Can't quite find him with the ball. Works outside the arc. Hoskins crosses over. Works to the glass. Two. Hoskins with 11. 34-22. It's a 12-point lead for the Admirals, and a timeout called by Medina. They're going to make it a full timeout, so we're going to step away for just a minute with 2:54 left in the third quarter. It's 34-22 in favor of the Admirals. You're listening to the Cool Cat 1380 and TV20 Lorain City Schools Television.
Your lawnmower needs service. Your snowblower doesn't work. Your riding mower needs repair. Who are you going to call? To avoid all this frustration and for no mower worries, call Mark Furman Mobile Mower Service at 315-0250. Mark Furman Mobile Mower Service makes good old-fashioned house calls. Most service is done on site at your home when it's convenient for you. Mark Furman Mobile Mower Service is one of the area's only authorized Briggs & Stratton mobile service dealers. He's been servicing the area's power equipment needs for over 30 years, servicing most makes, including Sears and MTD Yard Machines and other major name brands. Remember, for no mower worries and for fast, experienced, professional service, call Mark Furman Mobile Mower Service at 315-0250.
For the people in our armed forces, it's a time of sacrifice, a time of duty. That's why we've joined together to form the Armed Forces Relief Trust to help military families cope with financial and medical emergencies at home. The four military aid societies gave millions last year to cover unexpected medical expenses, child care, and more. But with so many overseas, the need is greater than ever. They're serving us. Let's serve them in return.
Welcome back, everyone, on the Cool Cat 1380 and also on Lorain City Schools Television. Real quick announcement here. Class of 1966 at Admiral King celebrating their 40th reunion here coming up pretty quick. If you need any information, call Neil Summers at 282-4600. He'll get you all the information as you get set to celebrate 40 years since you got out of school. Will omit all jokes at this point. Miller receives the inbounds pass, just under 3 minutes left in the third quarter. Admirals up by 12, 34-22 over Medina. Skubon with the ball for Medina, works to the top of the key, works right side, and Chester. He'll flip it back out to Skubon. Glass with the ball, thought about the shot, had it knocked away, picked it back up, tries the baseline drive, thought he might have stepped on the out-of-bounds line, no dice there. Somehow, Medina ends up with the ball. They've done that several times tonight. Bodies all over the place, and they end up with the ball. Skubon flips it out top to Glass. Deed up there by Mosley, tries the baseline drive, goes up strong, and got it. Glass with 14 points on the evening to lead all scorers. Hoskins works forward, shakes, bakes, goes toward the baseline, off the glass, no good. Rebound battle for, picked up by Lagarde, that one no good, follow no good. Hoskins with the putback, that one's good. King cleaning up on the boards. Medina will receive no pressure as they walk the ball up in the hands of McBride. Under 2 minutes left in the third quarter, 36-24 in favor of the Admirals. Glass with the ball. Lagarde will D him up, works across the top. McBride thought about the shot, no dice there. Skubon back to Glass. Glass will cut through the lane, no good. Hoskins will pull down the rebound. Hoskins across the timeline, sees the middle of the lane, goes up strong, misses the layup, put back, that one's no good. Rebound battle for, pulled down by Medina. Skubon will push forward for Medina, leaves it off right side for Chester. Layup is good, give him two, his first two of the ball game. 36-26, it's a 10-point lead for the Admirals.
And right now, Medina, of course, when they get the ball, they want to get out and run. Admiral King maybe rushing their offensive set a little bit. Danny Hoskins wants to get some shots up, but slow down, calm it down. There's still a lot of game left to be played. Spread it out, and that's what you're seeing them do right now.
1 minute left in the third quarter. Admiral King decides to go to the four corners offense. Kimbrough, Hoskins with the ball now. Mosley, Lagarde, and Pinkerton. Medina's going to sit in that 3-2 zone defense. Admiral King willing to wait. 42, 41, 40 seconds left on the third quarter clock. I'd say more, but there's no need. Not much happening, although Medina does start to come out of that defense. They'll flip it. Admiral King will flip to Kimbrough. Thought about the shot. Finds Lagarde in the lane. Up and one! Tough shot by Lagarde. Man on his back, still able to force it up with the right hand and push it in. That'll get Lagarde 6 points on the evening. Substitutions coming in for both squads. Adrian Casey and Jordan Simmons in for Admiral King. You see Mullenkamp and Micah back in for Medina.
A great pass by Kimbrough.
Wasn't it?
Just breaks his man down, gets to the hole, and passes off. That's a beautiful play.
38-26, a 12-point lead for the Admirals. Lagarde can bump it to 13 in the largest lead of the game, and does so. 7 points for Rashawn Lagarde, Admiral King. Miller will handle the ball with 20 seconds left for Medina. Still with the ball, D'd up out top. Actually, Darrell Williams into the game. Make sure I got the right people in there. I think I called him by Simmons' name just a minute ago. 7 seconds on the clock. Medina with the ball. Mullenkamp tries the right elbow, has the ball knocked away, retrieves it, somehow finds Mike on the baseline shot. No good. Rebound pulled down by Adrian Casey. That'll bring the third quarter to a close. 39-26 in favor of the Admirals. We're going to step away when we come back. It's fourth quarter time right here on the Cool Cat and TV20, Lorain City Schools Television.
The fight against arthritis isn't a walk in the park, but it's a start. Arthritis affects 66 million adults.
And 300,000 kids, like me. I'm Patrick, and I have juvenile arthritis. Walking for me can be a struggle, but I don't have to walk alone.
Join an arthritis walk team in your community today to help the Arthritis Foundation improve lives and find a cure. For more information, visit arthritis.org.
Hi, Mr. President. My parents believe that eating meals together will make our country strong. Is this something that you did when you were a kid?
I did eat with my family so long as my mother wasn't cooking.
It's not good making fun of your mother, even if you are president, but it is good to have dinner with your kids. We know the more often children have dinner with their families, the less likely they are to smoke, drink, and use drugs. So simply having dinner together can help your children forever, even if you're not a great cook.
8 minutes back on the fourth quarter clock here in Midview High School. The Admirals up 39-26 over the Medina Bees. It's a 13-point lead, but we are all kind of talking here. Joe Bach from Lorain City Schools Television, myself, Daryl Maynard. Not a comfortable lead right now for Admiral King. Maybe a little bit more comfortable than it was before. Medina just keeps hanging around there, making little mini runs.
Yeah, and I mean, that's something we've talked about. You just don't feel right. I mean, if you're an AK fan, you're kind of watching the game, you're listening to the game, and you're going, 8 minutes. Let's just get through eight more minutes, yeah, and we'll be fine. But sometimes 8 minutes can be a long time.
Medina's going to pick up the defensive pressure. Admiral King will get the ball and start the fourth quarter on the alternate possession. Hoskins looking for a little bit of help to get it in. He's facing a five count, stepped over the line. Turnover, Admiral King. Hoskins really frustrated. Not so much with himself, I think, but the fact that his teammates didn't find an open spot. All right, quick turnover, not the way to start the fourth quarter. McBride will inbounds to Glass. He'll walk it across the timeline, deed up by Lagarde, works to the left side, and Micah. Micah deed up by Pinkerton. He'll find McBride. McBride to Mullenkamp. Mullenkamp in the lane, passes off toward the baseline. Shot no good by Glass, gets his own rebound, works out of the key with it. Outside the arc, flips it right side. Mullenkamp, he'll spot the three. In and out, no good. Pinkerton, big rebound for the Admirals. He'll get it off to Hoskins. Hoskins will walk it up. We've seen Hoskins do this before. He'll play the point guard at 6'6". Slides into the lane, has the ball knocked away. Picked up by Medina's Scott Chester, and a double dribble called on Medina. Big turnover for Admiral King. Big turnover for Medina, big turnover for Admiral King as well.
Yeah, both ways. A good job of the AK defenders realizing there's three of them down there. Let's just surround him, see if we can get him to make a mistake.
13-point lead for the Admirals. Substitution coming into the game for Medina will be Will Hotelling. Looks as though Medina will start off this particular play in a 2-3 zone. Hoskins inbounds, finds Lagarde, looks to get it back. It's kicked by Glass out of bounds. Admiral King will have to inbound it yet again. Official spotting up Hoskins, who wanted it a little bit closer to the basket. Has to step out to where it actually went out of bounds.
Can't blame him for that, though.
No. Hey, if you can get it, why not? Pinkerton receives the inbounds pass, has the pocket picked by Mullenkamp, wants to push at the other end. Layup, that one a little strong off the glass. Rebound, battle for it. Glass will pick it up and literally roll it in over the top of the rim. 16 points for Glass. 39-28, 11-point lead for the Admirals. Kimbrough will work forward for Admiral King, find Pinkerton, lob pass goes into Hoskins. He'll flip it across the top. Mullenkamp will poke it away. He wants to push for the Bees. Leaves it forward to McBride. He can't quite hold on to it. Glass ends up with it again in the lane. No good on the putback. Pinkerton with the rebound. Glass is always around the ball.
I think there's more than one of him on the court.
I know, it's stunning. Kimbrough finds Pinkerton, works into the lane. He loses the ball. Glass picks it up. He's going to push. No foul called on that at the other end. And McBride will drop in the layup, give him 10 points, and a timeout called by Coach Michael Scott, the 32nd variety. With 6:28 left in the game, now 39-30. What was a 13-point lead, now a 9-point lead. And things just really helter-skelter, and that's serving Medina well right now.
Oh, yeah, they like the confusion, because what confusion does is creates turnovers. And Medina can get out and get on the run. They're ready to go, because the only person defensively back for Admiral King is Kimbrough, the smallest guy on the
exactly.
court.
6:28 left in the contest. Admiral King has never been ultimately comfortable in this contest. See exactly how they kind of work through the remainder of the 6 minutes and change. They can hold off this Medina team that's been very, very invested in scrapping for the ball. Kimbrough work across the timeline as we're back in play. Lob pass goes inside to Hoskins, goes up strong, and one. Boy, how quickly Admirals respond. Hoskins will get the deuce. They have the opportunity for the three-point play. And what was a nine-point lead is back out to 11, 41-30.
And I like the fact Hoskins gets the ball and he goes to the hoop. He doesn't sit around, doesn't wait, gets it, goes up strong, and that's just the way he has to play.
Hoskins hits the freebie at the other end. Ball goes out of bounds off of Admiral King's hand. Good job defensively just to kind of get back and break up the play. It'll be glass to inbounds for Medina. Lob pass goes into Micah, skies for it, pulls it down, goes back up in front of Hoskins and gets it to drop. Micah got up there a little bit. 6 foot four, jumped like 6 foot six. Mosley with the ball, bounce pass goes to Hoskins. About 15 feet away from the hoop, spins toward the right side block, kicks it back out to Mosley. Ball knocked away by Glass, and they say that it went out of bounds off of Hoskins. Will head the other way. How many times have we called Glass's name just for being around the ball?
I mean, if this guy was a, I don't know, if he plays football, he's a football player, he'd be the Ray Lewis of the football team.
True enough. Just under 6 minutes left in this one. Medina with the ball. I mean, Mullenkamp out top. Got the double team, and boy, a tough call against Hoskins. Moving his feet, but they're saying he thrusted his hips a little bit. That'll be foul number three on Danny Hoskins. Six team fouls, even more importantly right now against Admiral King. Next foul, Medina will start going to the line. Mullenkamp with the ball, kind of turned it over, no call, works to the blocks, got called for the travel there. The basketball gods giveth, the basketball gods taketh away.
That's the great thing about basketball. It can go back and forth so quickly. One call on one end you're not happy with can go right back against you on the other side.
Pinkerton with the ball now for Admiral King. He'll flip it out top to Mosley. Admiral King definitely wants to spread the floor a little bit. Mosley works into the lane, loses the handle on the ball, and McBride picked it up, forced it, ends up back in Hoskins' hands. His shot no good. Pinkerton goes sailing after it. Guess who? Glass pushing at the other end for Medina. Fakes the pass, takes the shot, no good. Kimbrough comes away with it. Has Pinkerton up ahead. Pinkerton into the lane. Five-footer's good. Pinkerton with 10 on the evening. Mullenkamp leaves it for Glass. Under 5 minutes now. It's 44-32 in favor of the Admirals. Glass out top, D'd up by Lagarde. He'll work right side to Hotelling. He's D'd up by Hoskins. He'll work a left side to Miller, D'd up by Kimbrough. Kimbrough will knock it away. Miller pulls it back and then forearm checks him. Leaves it to the baseline to Micah. He tries to drive, has to reconnect with the ball. Blocked shot by Pinkerton, picked up by Kimbrough. He's going to be double teamed and gets trapped and gets fouled. They'll call it on Miller. Pinkerton skied for that block.
Oh, he's got some hops. Just on the previous play when they were on the offensive end, he came out of nowhere and skied for a rebound. Didn't get it, but still just, you look up and can't believe he's there.
Foul was called on Paul Glass of Medina. That'll be his third, team fifth. And a timeout called by Jody Peters, the head coach of the Medina Bees. It's a full timeout. That means we get to take one as well with 4:26 left in the fourth quarter. It's Admiral King 44, Medina 32. We'll be right back on the Cool Cat 1380 and TV20 Lorain City Schools Television.
Learn more in high school, earn more in life. Right here in Northeast Ohio, thousands of high school students are making the choice. They're applying today for career and technical education programs, gaining specialized skills for rewarding careers and college. Lorain area students apply today for fall 2006 programs. Call today for high-tech programs that offer college tech prep credit or articulated college credit with local colleges and universities. Career and technical education. Apply today.
Hi, I'm Russell Simmons. Today I want to talk to you about a very important subject. Cruelty to animals. Emmy was a victim of cruelty and someone did something about it. Someone called the ASPCA and put an end to it because Emmy can't talk. The fact is, animals are abused all over this country and people sit by and do nothing. It's not slick or fly or cool or none of that. It's just cruel. If you're aware of any animal abuse, go to ASPCA.org to find out what you can do now and make a difference. She can't do it for herself.
Medina will not go away. Admiral King able to maintain the lead, 44-32. as we hit the 4:26 mark in the fourth quarter. Don Vince along with Daryl Maynard on Cool Town 1380 and TV 20, Lorain City Schools Television, bringing a great basketball action from Midview High School in Grafton. You're just kind of waiting for one team or the other to make this big run. It just gives you some confidence that either this is going to be a real tight one at the end or someone's just going to walk away with the win. Neither team really, I don't think either coach will be ultimately happy with the performances.
No, whichever team moves on, they have some work to do before Agreed. Their next game.
Pinkerton gets trapped along the near sideline. He'll go long cross court to Hoskins. Pump fake goes up strong, draws the contact, goes to the line for a couple of freebies. You got choices here. It could have been either hoteling or perhaps Scuban on the foul. They're going to call hoteling, and that'll be his fourth, team six. So from now on, every foul, with the exception of offensive fouls, we're going to the line. Danny Hoskins with 16 on the evening. Make it 17. Leads all scorers, although Paul Glass is sitting right behind him with 16 from Medina. Hoskins will set for number two. Dips, puts it up, and drains it. 18 points for Danny Hoskins, the 6'6" senior forward for these Admirals.
And six of nine from the charity stripe tonight.
Nice, good number. McBride with the ball, works it inside. Hotelling stops in the middle of the key, a little strong on his shot, and Hoskins just rips it down with one arm and then cradles it. He'll hand off to Kimbrough, to Pinkerton, near sideline. Pinkerton will be trapped, and then go cross court to Simmons. Simmons will back off, now Kimbrough. Lagarde also on the floor with Hoskins and Pinkerton. Pinkerton with the ball, looked underneath, nothing doing there. Flips it out top to Simmons, got bumped, no call. Finds Hoskins along the baseline, goes up with a shot, contact, no foul, out of bounds off of Medina. Mosley will report in for Admiral King. Paul Glass will report in for Medina. Also up off the bench for Medina is Clay Mullenkamp. 3:41 left, fourth quarter. It's 46-32 in favor of the Admirals. Pinkerton, fire the inbounds. He'll find Kimbrough. He'll center up top, goes to Mosley. Mosley to the baseline and Simmons. Mosley will get it back, flip it out top to Kimbrough. Fakes the drive, backs off, goes to Hoskins. Hoskins facing a 5-second count, flips it to the baseline and Simmons. Had a shot, passed it up, took it from 5 feet anyway, no good on the shot. Hotelling with the rebound. Hands off to Miller. Comes across the timeline. D'd up by Simmons. Works right side to Glass. Glass with the drive. Into the paint. Shot blocked. Foul called on Admiral King. Send Glass to the line. See who they call it on. I believe they're going to call it on Pinkerton. If that's the case, it'll be his second. Glass will go to the line with 16 points on the evening.
And if I was Pinkerton, I'd have walked right up to the ref and raised my hand and said, yep, it was me. You don't want Hoskins to pick up his fourth.
Absolutely.
And have to worry about that.
Michael will report back in for Medina. Sitting down will be hoteling. Crowd filing in for the second game tonight. They're getting entertained here by a pretty decent game right now. Glass hits the second, 17 points for him. Full court pressure now by Medina. Kimbrough will work with Hoskins against the pressure. They'll get it forward to Pinkerton. Pinkerton along the sideline has the ball ripped away by McBride. McBride at the other end, layup. Foul called on Kimbrough. Didn't want to give up the easy one. Not a bad foul, to be honest with you. Kimbrough's got it to give.
No, it's one of those fouls where you want to be able to stop him from not completing a three-point play, but you don't want to foul him hard enough so it looks like a cheap foul.
Full timeout called by Medina. We're going to actually called by Admiral King. We're going to step away with 3:03 left in the contest. It's 46-33 in favor of the Admirals. We'll be right back on the Cool Cat 1380 and TV 20 Lorain City Schools Television.
My dad is a hero. He goes into places normal people want to get away from. He rescues families, makes everyone safe. But the best thing he can do is come home.
The U.S. Fire Administration reminds you to protect the heroes who protect our lives. Have a smoke alarm on every floor. Test it monthly. Replace the battery yearly. Do your part to get out before they have to come in.
Across America, Service Learning is helping students improve their grades and their communities by connecting the classroom with community service.
Working together, students solve real problems, build new skills, and apply their knowledge in a whole new way. Inside the classroom and out, service learning opens new doors and brings learning to life. Get your school involved. Visit learnandserve.gov to find out how.
3:03 left in this one. Admiral King enjoying a 46-33 lead as we get set to rejoin fourth quarter action. The Admirals have led throughout this contest. I don't think they've ever really been comfortable throughout this contest.
No, it's been one of those games. Like we've just been saying, there really hasn't been a change in it. But I mean, with we look at 3:03 left to play on the clock, this is where Medina's going to need to get to the line. They're going to need to make a difference here and get back in this game because time's running out against the rest of your season.
Woody McBride at the free throw line. He's got two shots coming to him. Sets for the first, puts it up. That one's good. McBride with 11 on the evening. Both teams paced by two scorers, essentially. McBride hits the second, gives him 12. It's McBride in glass for Medina. For Admiral King, it's Pinkerton and Hoskins. That's kind of the norm. Hoskins with the ball right now, facing big pressure, goes long pass. It'll go out of bounds at the other end of the court. They threw it at about one-third court, and it ended up going out of bounds at the other end. Kind of effortless over-the-head pass. Medina will take the ball out following that errant pass, the turnover. Bounce it forward to Mullenkamp. Waits very patiently, trying to preserve some time. Glass the ball out top to Miller. Miller into the lane. Nice pass goes to Glass along the baseline. And two more for Glass, 19. He takes over the lead for all scorers. Kimbrough with the ball now for Admiral King. Leaves it forward to Simmons. Gets knocked on his can. Layup at the other end by Simmons. No good. He'll track down his own rebound. Looking for a little bit of help. Gets the shot anyway off the spin. Got it. Simmons, just his third and fourth points in the game, but big ones nonetheless. 2:20 left in the contest. Mullenkamp goes to the other end. High off the glass, no good. That would have been a garbage shot. Hoskins will pull down the rebound, get trapped, get it out to Kimbrough. Kimbrough trapped again, gets it forward to Mosley. Mosley goes for the shot at the other end, gets it. A lot of contact, no call. Mosley with 10 points now. And it's 50-37 in favor of Admiral King with under 2 minutes left. You think the Admirals are starting to get a little bit more comfortable?
I'd have to say that shirt's feeling a little bit better, yeah.
McBride with the ball for Medina. Leaves it underneath for Glass, forces up a shot. They're going to call a foul on Admiral King. And it's either Simmons or Hoskins, and it's going to be Hoskins as the official puts up the 4-2. That'll be foul number four on Danny Hoskins. 50-37. And a timeout called by Medina's Jody Peters. We're going to go ahead and keep it right here with a 1:45 left on the fourth quarter clock. Admiral King jumped out at the beginning of the first quarter with a 10-0 lead at the end of the quarter. Pretty amazing defense there. At the half, it was 21-11. Still that 10-point lead. At the end of the third quarter, 39-26, a 13-point lead. It's that 10 points that was spotted Admiral King at the beginning of the game that's really played big against the Medina Bees. Now, I don't want to say that Admiral King didn't earn that 10-0 lead because their defense was certainly superb, but that's going to come back and almost be a nightmare for Jody Peters and his Bees.
Oh, completely. I mean, anytime you have to come back against a good team, it's tough. When it's 10 points and you come off, just the emotion of not scoring at all in the first quarter.
Exactly.
This is a big tourney game. You want to come in and prove that you deserve to be here. When you come in and put up a blank on the board, that's going to wear on you a little bit. What would the game be like if it was a little different? I'd agree. But then again, Admiral King missed a lot of shots in that first quarter, and I thought could have easily been up 17, 18, even 20 points instead of 10.
I don't think there's any question about it, Daryl, and give Admiral King credit. And it'll be interesting to see. I will assume right now that they're going to hold on and win this one. I mean, they're up by 13 with 1:45 on the clock. It'll be interesting to see when Michael Scott comes up here and talks to us after the game exactly where he is with this game. Be interesting to see his analysis following ours. Glass with the free throw, drops it for Medina. Coming off of the timeout, 20 points for Glass on the evening, the 6'2 senior guard. Has a nose for the ball. He went into the locker room at the half with six and has really turned it up here in the second half. 21 points for him now. It's 50-39 in favor of the Admirals. Mosley gets the inbounds pass. He'll go back to Hoskins. Hoskins working into the trap, finds Kimbrough. Kimbrough very quickly forward to Lagarde, back out top. Kimbrough fouled. He'll go to the line for the 1-1. Actually, check that. He's going to get two shots now. They're in the double bonus. Sub set to come in for Medina is Will Hotelling. Sitting down will be Russ Micah. Actually, the official saying it's still a 1-1. Perhaps I was a little premature on that. Kimbrough with 1 point on the evening, and still will have that 1 point. Rebound battle for, finally picked up by McBride. He'll work across the timeline, had his pocket picked by Kimbrough, ends up with the ball again, spots the three, misses everything, air ball, and he'll hear it from the Admiral King faithful. There it is. Hoskins to inbound for Admiral King again. Situational substitutions for Medina. Michael will trot onto the court. Hotelling will sit down. Michael will jump right up in Hoskins' face. Hoskins won't back off at all. Hoskins gonna face a five count, gets it into Pinkerton. He's wrapped up from behind by McBride. That'll be the first foul on McBride, I think. We'll walk down to the other end. This time, I'm sure, two shots coming his way. No.
No, nope, I don't believe so.
I guess
so.
I'm looking at the wrong side of the scoreboard. Thanks, John. You could have done that last time, too, there, buddy. John Jenkinson, our engineer, is flashing me hand signals, most of them polite. Pinkerton at the free throw line, misses the front end of the 1-1. Got it right this time. Miller will push forward for Medina. Leaves it off, Mullenkamp. Nice pass to Glass underneath. Glass with another deuce, 23 points on the night, 50-41. It's a 9-point lead. Just over a minute left in this one. And we're gonna go back down and shoot some more free throws. How many are we gonna shoot this time, Darryl?
This time, I believe it's gonna be two. Let me check the board.
Nope. Nope, I don't think so. 50-41 in favor of the Admirals with 1:09 left on the fourth quarter clock. Hoskins sets for the front end of the 1-1. Bounces it off the back of the rim. Admiral King not hitting their free throws. Glass with the rebound. He wants to go coast to coast. Does so. Off the glass. Good. This one's not quite over yet. 25 for him. 50-43. Long pass forward goes to Lagarde. To Pinkerton. Two hands on the dunk. Mullenkamp comes forward from Medina. Tries to go between his legs. Shovel pass into the lane. And Hotelling, that gives him his first two of the game. Kimbrough facing big pressure, gets wrapped up, gets fouled. We'll walk down to the other end. Now we'll shoot two. Think we've got it covered now. 39.4 seconds left in the fourth quarter. That dunk, a big play. Bumps out the lead a little bit more, but just kind of makes a statement.
It's a pickup, but I tell you right now, whether he's shooting two shots or he's shooting a 1-1, he needs to make them.
True enough. Kimbrough with 1 point on the evening. Misses the first, just rolls it along the rim. Wow.
Kimbrough, 1 of 4 from the charity stripe tonight.
Well, let's bump it up to 2 and 5. There it is. Hits it, 2 points on the evening. Miller with the ball from Medina across the timeline, 35 seconds on the fourth quarter clock, works his way into the lane, flips up the layup, no good. He'll go to the line for a couple of freebies. Want to invite everybody to stick around for the post-game show. It's brought to you by LorainCounty.com. We'll spend some time with Coach Michael Scott and a couple of the players, and that'll be foul number 5 on Danny Hoskins. He'll sit down. His numbers on the night, 18 points, a ton of rebounds, and just a great job all around. Probably one of the guys we'll want to talk to after the game, you think?
I'd agree. I remember talking to him before the last game that we did, and be more than happy to talk to him again today after this game.
Bring him up here to the booth at Midview High School. Won't have to go down to the floor quite this time. Of course, we get chased off the floor. They'll be doing warm-ups for game number 2 tonight. 34.5 seconds left in this contest. 53-45 in favor of the Admirals. Maybe David Hoosier, or check that. Nate Miller at the line. Hits the first. The Bees setting up their defense following this free throw. It's good. They give Miller 3 points on the evening. Pinkerton throws the turnover to McBride. McBride shot blocked by Pinkerton, and Miller will come down with the ball, but a foul called on Simmons. Oh, and Medina's just not willing to go away. 29.5 seconds left in the contest, 53-47.
And what would the difference be if they'd have made a couple baskets drop in that first quarter?
Timeout called by the Admirals. We're going to take one as well. Under 30 seconds left in this one. It's only a 6-point lead. We'll be right back on the Cool Cat 1380 and TV 20 Lorain City Schools Television.
Hi, this is Tim McGraw. Today and every day is the right time to support the American Red Cross, who gives disaster assistance to people when they need it most. You can help the victims of thousands of disasters across the country each year by making a financial gift to the American Red Cross Disaster Relief Fund, which enables the Red Cross to provide shelter, food, counseling, and other assistance to those in need. Please call 1-800-HELP now. Together, we can save a life.
You might take meth because of how it feels. But this is how it feels to your heart. The only difference is you can't rebuild a heart.
All right, we're going to bring this one to a close here, we think. 29.5 seconds left. Fourth quarter from Midview High School sectional final action. The Admirals have been up throughout the game. It's 53-47. They were up by 13, it seems like, just seconds ago in terms of clock time, Darrell.
Well, I tell you, if AK makes it on to the next round, I know one thing they'll definitely be doing this week, and it's called free throws.
We'll get to those numbers here in just a minute, sense of exactly where they've been from the free throw line. Well, you know what, it's not terrible. Count those up if you can real quick. The other end of the court, Miller hits a free throw, gives him 4 points on the evening, makes it 53-48 in favor of the Admirals. Second by Miller is on the way, that one's good as well. All of his 5 points have been from the free throw line. Kimbrough to inbound. Finds Pinkerton. Pinkerton with the ball back to Kimbrough. Kimbrough will work it forward to Simmons. Simmons has Lagarde down court. Gets it to him in the middle of the lane. He's going to travel. No, they're going to call a foul. I thought he might have slid his feet. Lagarde will go to the free throw line. The Medina fans not digging it. They may have an argument. 21.4 seconds left in this contest, 53-49. What's the numbers look like? Oh, well, you were right. 13 of 22 for the Admirals from the line. A little bit better than 50%. Foul was called on Paul Glass. That's his fifth, so he'll have to sit down, thus the delay on the court right now. Send Lagarde to the line. Buzzer sounds calling someone in. It'll be Skuban. I think he's got to report in before the free throw. There you go. Glass will sit down. He's played a whale of a game for Medina. 25 points. It's a heck of a night for the senior. Lagarde. Bounces three, dips once, shot up, hard off the iron, no good. Another missed free throw, 53-49. Favor of Admiral King, 21.4 seconds left in the contest. Lagarde's second one, that one also no good. Rebound pulled down by Hotelling. Skuban will push forward, leaves it left side. McBride, three-pointer, off the rim, no good. Hotelling with the rebound, put back. That one's off hard. Pinkerton with the big rebound for Admiral King, gets tied up. We'll head down to the other end for a couple more free throws. 8.7 seconds left in the contest. Joe Bach shakes his head, yes, I like where things are right now. If you're an Admiral King fan, you ought to be liking them as well. 8.7 seconds left on the clock, 53-49. Pinkerton with a couple of freebies coming his way. Pinkerton hits the first, gives him 13 points on the evening. Walks away from the line, gets set to go back and go to work. Got it. 55-49. Favor the Admirals. Miller will work forward for Medina. Leaves off. McBride takes the three. That one short off the left side. Rebound Lagarde. Buzzer. Game is over. 55-49 in favor of the Admirals. It was a battle. Spotted themselves, gave themselves a 10-point lead, let it dwindle down to about 6 points, actually 4 points at one point in the fourth quarter before pulling it out. The battle throughout the game for Admiral King, but did what they needed to do to wrap this one up.
Overall, it's all about getting the victory at the end of the game. Does your team have the will and know how to get it done, or do they fall apart? The Admirals able to get it done tonight.
With that, we're going to step away for just a minute. When we come back, it'll be our post-game show brought to you by LorainCounty.com. Hopefully, we'll have a moment to speak with Michael Scott, as well as a couple of the Admirals. Jay Pinkerton and Danny Hoskins are on our roster, the guys that we think we'd like to talk to. We'll see if they'll come up and spend a couple minutes with us. We'll be right back. You're listening to the Cool Cat 1380 and watching on TV 20 Lorain City Schools Television.
It's something we all agree on. It's something we all do. And this is how it's done. The USO depends entirely on the generosity of the American people. Help us support our troops until everyone comes home.
I get people involved in saving the environment. That's why I volunteer.
When I teach computer skills, I help kids succeed in school. That's why I volunteer.
I help to raise awareness about the hazards of tobacco use. That's why I volunteer, to make a difference.
If you know middle or high school students who make a difference by doing volunteer work, have them ask their school principals about applying for a Prudential Spirit of Community Award. Or encourage them to call 1-888-450-9961.
Don Vincent along with Daryl Maynard as we wrap things up here from Midview High School on the Cool Cat 1380 and TV 20 Lorain City Schools Television. It was a battle for Admiral King throughout, despite the fact that they got themselves a 10-point lead to start things off in the first quarter. That's exactly where the quarter ended, at 10-0 in favor of the Admirals. But Medina was more than game. They stuck around throughout the evening, were as close as 4 points away with just seconds left in the fourth quarter. But Admiral King able to pull this one out in pretty good fashion, 55-49 over the Medina Bees. Don Vincent along with Daryl Maynard as we continue to scratch our numbers down and make sure we've got all the analysis for you right here on the LorainCounty.com post-game show. Remember, each and every game here on the Lorain County Sports Network is brought to you simulcast and on the archives at LorainCounty.com/WDLW. It's all about Lorain County. It's all about you. Join your neighbors and log on to LorainCounty.com. I want to remind everybody listening live right now, you can check this game out on video on Channel 20, TV 20, Lorain City Schools Television in Lorain. That'll be March 6th, Monday evening, from at 3:30 and at 7:30. Again, Don Vincent along with Daryl Maynard. Daryl, in this particular kind of game, you find an Admiral King squad that's got a lot of skills and a lot of ability, challenged by a Medina squad that certainly was game, but just wouldn't go away. Admiral King could not put away this Medina squad.
And you got to give them credit for sticking in there and staying with it. Admiral King's got a lot of things they need to work on when it comes to their next game. Medina, they can't feel ashamed for anything that they did tonight, although that first quarter hurts. You just can't deny that.
It hurts quite a bit. You spot a team 10 points, you end up losing by a fairly narrow margin of 6 points on an evening like this, and you go back and you think, what if? What could it have been like had they been able to at least match them point for point in the first quarter? Admiral King, and I'm sure we're going to hear this from Michael Scott when he comes up and spends a couple minutes with us, they're going to pride themselves on the shutout in the first quarter. That's what Michael Scott wants to do with his ball club. Would have liked to have seen a few more points on the board as well. And right now, we're going to be joined by some of the Admirals. Let me go ahead and reach behind my partner here and grab a mic. First up is going to be Jay Pinkerton. And Jay, first off, I want to thank you for coming up and joining us and congratulate you on a nice game. This was a struggle for you guys from word one. I mean, you got out to that 10-point lead, but from there on, Medina just kind of hung around.
Yeah, they hung around. We didn't expect them really to hang around. We came out trying to play hard and press them. So we got a lot of turnovers on it, but they stuck in the game on it.
No, one of the things that we noted, particularly in the first half, Jay, was that you seemed to be struggling a little bit to find your game. But in the second half in particular, you found it and you made your contributions. Maybe not huge in terms of points, but just your defense and your ability to help out.
Right. Yeah, I had to help out a lot, blocked a couple shots. I wasn't hitting nothing in the beginning, so I knew I had to step up in the second half because I'm a senior. This is my last chance if we lost. So I had to step up and go all out.
Yeah, and I mean, obviously being a senior plays a lot into it. When Danny went down, got his fouls, had to go out of the game, did you feel it was up to you to get down there, get low, get some rebounds, and help the team out?
Yeah, I knew it was up to me to step in when Danny went out. I didn't even know he had five fouls. I knew I had to step up, though. It was a big thing to do.
Talk about the dunk. When you saw the pass coming, did you start getting excited? I know that it wasn't as hard as some of the dunks I've seen you throw down. Did you back off on it a little bit?
Make sure it go in. I mean, just get across on by and make sure it went in.
I think it's pretty critical at that point. That was a point in the game when Medina was mounting another one of their comebacks, and that dunk kind of backed them off a little bit. Right. You've got to give credit to Medina. They played hard tonight.
Yeah, they played hard tonight. They stuck in with us tonight. I give them credit for that.
Jay, I want to thank you for spending a couple minutes with us. Congratulations on the win. We're going to be back here to watch you guys as you play a little bit more tournament basketball.
Thank you for having me.
Jay Pinkerton spending a couple minutes with us on the LorainCounty.com postgame show. Next up on the mic, the man with the leading numbers, Danny Hoskins. And, what do you say? I mean, it's just another great game for you. Did you have fun at all tonight? Or was this all about the business?
All about the business. Ain't no more fun, no more. All about business now.
As you came into tonight, what did you get what you expected from Medina tonight?
Yeah. Yep.
Talk a little bit in particular about that first quarter. You guys jumped out to that 10-0 lead at the end of the first quarter. Defensively, I mean, you guys were hitting on all cylinders.
Yeah, that's what the coach stressed to us, to come out in the first half and just try to dominate, because we usually come out in the first half shaky and then come out in the second half and be a strong team. He wanted us to do all four quarters tonight, and we did it.
A lot of teams, Danny, when they get out to a lead 10-0, they shut a team out in the first quarter. And then when it gets down to the fourth quarter, you're only up 3, 4, 5 points. It makes a good team to have the chemistry to get together and pull together and win that game. Do you feel that's a bonus for your team, having the seniors, four starting seniors on the team?
Yep, that's what it is. And having everybody on the team know their role. Everybody know what to do, and they know what to think, what to go through, and who to go through, and who to go to at the end.
When you guys come into games like this tonight, do you feel the pressure on you on yourselves? Do you come in, or are you guys loose?
We loose, because we ready. We come in for war, and we the underdogs. That's how we take every game, like we the underdogs.
Well, the following game tonight here at Midview High School will feature North Olmsted and Strongsville. Strongsville, the number one seed. You guys were, I think, the number four seed in the tournament. Do you care who you play, or you just want to play the game?
Just want to play the game. I'd rather play Strongsville because they're number one seed, and we feel we should have number one seed. But whoever wins, that's who we come out to play. That's the next game.
Bring on the big boys. Next game's going to be on the 8th at 7 o'clock. We're going to be here with you. Looking forward to more great Admiral action.
Thanks.
All right, Danny Hoskins from the Admiral King Admirals, big night tonight. And the coach, Michael Scott. Now,
you guys want to go get tennis?
Michael, taking care of the guys. We mentioned at the beginning of the game, Mike, you already had the jacket off. You already had the sleeves rolled up. You came in for business on this one.
Well, you know, this is something that hasn't been done in Admiral King in a while, and that's right. Get that tournament W. So, you know, it was a business attitude. We had a great week of practice. You know, unfortunately, we had a couple guys go down with some injuries and some illness, but that just made us work a little bit harder and have a more focused approach to the game.
Let's talk about one of those injuries. Paris Hilliard injured his foot or ankle. His ankle?
His it ankle. It was his ankle on the opposite foot that he had hurt.
Oh,
so,
okay.
You know, it goes from one extreme to the other with Paris. But in Paris's regard, he did a great job of being a leader this week and coaching up some of the younger guys and getting them ready for the tournament atmosphere.
Well, and you mentioned coaching up some of the younger guys. One guy in particular, Chris Kimbrough, your freshman guard, who played a great game tonight, really handled the ball very well. I'm sure that pleases you, not only from a performance perspective tonight, but from a future perspective.
Well, yeah, I mean, he's our floor general. He's been our floor general since day one. And each game he's gotten better. And he handled some heat down there down the stretch.
Yeah,
and I'm proud of him. And ultimately, he's also our best defender. I mean, he gets after like no other. And as a freshman, to take that sort of challenge against some of these better guards all year, and we face some of the better guards in Northeastern Ohio, and he's been with them every step of the way. So the future looks bright for him.
No doubt.
I mean, we talked about the learning experience for Kimbrough, being a freshman, playing and starting with four seniors. And those four seniors stepped up and filled in the stat books tonight. That has to make you proud as a coach.
Well, definitely, because, you know, I remember last year we didn't win this game. And those they were juniors then, they vowed to make it a point to not let that happen again. And they came in with a focused attitude for the tournament, and all year. All year, the seniors have been big for them. And that's what you want out of a program. That's how tradition gets built.
Now, I'm going to ask you the same question I kind of wrap things up with Danny. Right now, in fact, warming up, North Olmsted and Strongsville, the winner of that game is the team that you play on the 8th. You got a preference?
We want Strongsville.
Same answer.
I mean, we want to play the best, and we don't want to take, well, you guys have, you know, North Olmsted. And don't get me wrong, North Olmsted they're a dangerous team.
Yes, they are.
And they might knock off Strongsville tonight, but we want Strongsville, because all year, all we've heard is Strongsville, Strongsville, Strongsville. Strongsville's a team that's ranked 8th in the Blaine Dealer, so on and so forth. They're the team that likes to run and gun. Well, we'll see on Wednesday who we have, whoever it is. We're going to come with a focused attitude, play the role of the underdog, and strive. Strive for greatness.
No question, you're going to spend the rest of the evening checking out the action here, right?
Yeah, I look forward to checking that out, too.
No doubt about it. We're going to stick around for a while as well. Michael Scott, I want to thank you for joining us both on the Cool Cat 1380 and on WLCS, Lorain City Schools Television.
Once again, thanks for the effort. I mean, you guys are tremendous. I appreciate it.
We appreciate your time. Michael Scott, the head coach of the Admiral King Admiral, spending a couple minutes with us on the LorainCounty.com postgame show. Don Vince along with Daryl Maynard. We're going to step away for just a minute. When we come back, numbers, analysis, and we'll wrap things up here from Midview High School. Again, Admiral King, a big winner tonight, 55-49 over Medina. We'll be right back on the Cool Cat 1380 and WLCS.
Some dogs fetch and roll over. Some dogs take you to Spain and shopping for refrigerators. Help you get through grad school, start your own business, go on hikes in the Grand Canyon. Some dogs you trust with your life every day. Being partners with a guide dog is having the freedom to do what you want in life. Nothing more, nothing less. And with your help, nothing need ever change that. Call 1-888-884-DOGS or visit guidedogs.com.
Thank you very much, Brian. Don Vincent along with Daryl Maynard as we get set to wrap things up here from Midview High School. One more time with you. Again, the final tonight, Emerald King 55, the Medina Bees 49. On sectional final action, they'll take on the winner of the game two tonight, North Olmsted versus Strongsville. Strongsville, the number one seed. We already heard that the Admirals want to see Strongsville. They want to take them on.
Nothing better than being the underdog. You want to take the team that you've been achieving to beat, the team that you've been wanting to be all year. You want to take on Strongsville? Tell them that's who you want. Hopefully that'll be the matchup.
I'm sure that Strongsville knows that Admiral King's waiting in the wings for him, and I'm sure that they were here watching this game as well. Coaches from both North Olmsted and Strongsville, I spotted them both, and they were here early checking all the action out. Tell you what, now as we begin to work through your LorainCounty.com postgame show, why don't we go ahead and take a look at some of the numbers from the Admiral King and Medina game.
Well, we'll start off with the Medina Bees going 18 of 43 from inside the two-point arc for 41%. Very respectable considering they started off the first half shooting 31%. From the field. However, no love from behind the arc. They went 0-8 from three-point land, but they did make some points up in the free throw line, going 13-17, shooting 76%. For the Admirals, pretty much the same identical stats, really.
That's the weird part of this game.
If you look at it, 17 of 42 from inside the arc, 40%. The Bees, 41%. The only real difference you see is a couple three-pointers made, 2 of 10, 20%, and from the line, something that they're going to definitely need to work on if they do play Strongsville or North Olmsted, either team, 15 of 26 from the free throw line, 57%.
And the frustrating part of that is you do all the work to get yourself to the free throw line, and then you can't convert when it comes down to crunch time. That's certainly an area that the Admirals are going to have to improve upon if they move forward into the tournament. We'll look at some individual individual numbers right now for the Medina Bees, wrapping up their season at 10-12. You know, the big man for them was Paul Glass, the 6'2" senior guard, had 25 points on the evening, was always around the ball, Darryl.
Yeah, I mean, this is a guy who was a senior. He realized it was his last game, and he was going to leave everything he could on the court. He wasn't going to go home and think, well, I could have done a little bit more. He did everything he possibly could.
Clay Mullenkamp added a point, as did Dylan McBride. He put in 12. Scott Chester with a deuce tonight. Nate Miller with 5 points on the evening. Will Hotelling with 2. And Russ Michael with 2 as well. Medina spotted Admiral King those 10 points at the beginning of the game. They did not score in the first quarter, followed up with quarters of 11, 15, and 23 for a total of 49 points on the evening. For the Admiral King Admirals, they bumped their record up to 14-7 following tonight's win. And you know, Paris Hilliard, I think, with big loss, didn't play tonight because of that injury. Probably won't play for the remainder of the season. It's a shame. We've seen him over the years, always have enjoyed the way he played the game. Good to see him with the team and taking a leadership role. It was Chris Kimbrough, the floor general for the Admirals tonight, only scoring 2 points, but his contributions defensively, as we heard Coach Michael Scott talk about, and just in terms of managing the floor, were fantastic.
Yeah, you don't need to do it all. You just got to know your role, just what Danny Hoskins said before in the interview. Everyone knows what they're supposed to do, and as long as that happens, they're going to have a good chance to keep going on in this tournament.
Derek Mosley added 10 points to the effort tonight, and most of those in the first half and the third quarter. Jordan Simmons added 4 as well, and then the two big guys scoring a bulk of the points for Admiral King. Jay Pinkerton with 14 points, including that big slam at the end of the game, kind of built the momentum back up for just a moment before Medina tried to suck it away. He played a great game coming back from a really tough first quarter.
Yeah, tough first quarter, but came back, got on the floor, had 3 or 4 big blocks down low, and that's what you got to do. When the shot's not falling for you, you got to find another way to add to the team and help get the victory.
And then Danny Hoskins, 18 points on the night. I'm guessing he was somewhere around the 13 or 14 rebound mark easily. I mean, he was just raking the boards, particularly in the first part of the game. Admiral King was not shooting great from the floor, but had 3 and 4 opportunities at their end of the court almost every time based on his rebounding. So, I mean, if there's a player of the game to give it away, it's Danny Hoskins tonight. I don't think there's any doubt about that.
No, not at all. He put the team on his back in the first quarter, helped through, and played great basketball right up until he fouled out in the fourth.
That leads us to our one award that we do have to give away this evening. It's tonight's Garbage Bucket of the Game. It's brought to you by your friends at BFI Allied Waste Services. Our name has changed, but the service is the same. The one that I have written down is at the 425 mark in the third. We got the same one marked down. Emmer King took the shot, the ball hit the floor, was going out of bounds. Medina saved it back in bounds, but they saved it right to Rashawn Lagarde, and he just put up the chippy.
Yeah, nothing like a good Christmas gift right underneath the basket, 2 points.
And with that will bring our post-game show to a close. It's time for us to say goodbye. Before we do that, we want to say thank you to a whole lot of folks, certainly to Midview Tournament Manager Rod Eckenrode, puts on a great show here at Midview High School. The ladies back in the hospitality room always taking care of us and looking out for us as well. Ladies and one guy, I understand. I want to make sure I give credit where credit's due. Certainly to our on-site engineer, John Jenkinson, taking care of us, to our good friend behind the camera, Joe Bach from WLCS TV20, Lorain City Schools Television, and certainly our producer, young Brian. Ryan Dietz back at the station, keeping us on the air.
And legal.
No doubt about it. Our next game here on the Lorain County Sports Network, actually we want to invite the folks that are listening to us live to join our sister station, Gold Country 1320, tonight for coverage from Boys Division 4 sectional finals in Strongsville. Oberlin takes on Maplin. It'll be Jim Brady and Wally Minnis with all the action there tomorrow afternoon right here on the Cool Cat. Girls Division 1 district final from Medina, Elyria versus Amherst. I'll be there with Jim Brady, Community Health Partners and Allen Medical Center. Pre-game show begins at 12:45, and then tomorrow night a couple more games right here from Midview. It's Division 1 sectional final featuring Elyria versus Amherst in game 1, followed by Southview versus Brunswick in game 2. With that, for my partner Darryl Maynard, I'm Don Vincent saying good night from Midview High School.
This has been a production of Lorain City Schools TV20 WLCS.
To purchase a high-quality copy of the program you just viewed, please call Lorain City Schools Television at 282-8400.